Well, I think that's my cue. Good morning, Grand Avenue. How are we doing today? It's good to see you all. It's good to see you all. A little bit cooler today. Well, let's get to it. I'm sick and tired of hospitals. Very tired of hospitals. So all of you that have to go there on a continual basis for this and that, I've got new empathy. Well, Wichita wasn't the best in the world. They kept me for 4 days and gave me a bill and said, we don't know what's going on. But I ran into a tremendous doctor in Kansas City this last week. I really like her. She's one of the best in her field. And she put a name to it. And gave me an answer. Now, I'm not going to be able to give you the name because I don't have 30 minutes, but it's PPPD, okay? That's what I have. And I checked the boxes on all the symptoms, so we think that's what we're working on right now. At least I have somebody that's told me something. They're putting me on a new medicine, and in addition to the medicine, I'm going to be starting therapy at Salina Regional. There's a physical therapy that goes with this that's very specific that not too many hospitals have, but I'm really lucky Salina Regional does have a service for this. So hopefully. I've been on medicine for 2 days, taking about a week or so to get some answers on that. But I was really pleased with her. We went clear back to my stroke and before and did a progression, almost a day-by-day progression until we had all the answers. So I'm really pleased and really pleased to have an end to this, and now we're just going to move forward and get me fixed. How about that? I could not have done this without not only your prayers, but all the prayers. I've had prayers from far and wide. And I've been very discouraged about this, many of you know. And it's only through the prayers and through our Lord and Savior that I got through this without just checking into the nearest mortuary, I guess. I don't know. But I was sure tired. So thank you all for everything that you've done for me and for putting up with me and my lapses of speech and everything that you put up with, let's put it that way. Before I turn over for announcements, we have a couple announcements that weren't on the list. Number one, Lynn says that after service is over, there is fresh produce from the garden. We'll be out in the entryway here. So please stop by and pick up some vegetables from our garden. And thank you to all the guys that have been helping with the garden. I won't name y'all, but you know who you are. So thank you for that. A little late to get on the news. Carrie Aldridge called me last night. Carolyn Salinas' mother, now she hasn't been here for a while because she's been dealing with her mother, who's been in ill health for a long time. But she had a fall and smashed her pelvis. And she's got a brain bleed, and they're thinking that now we're going to have to put her in hospice. So please be praying for, I can't think of her mother's name.
Pat.
Okay. Pat, thank you, Carolyn. I just got that news last night, so please put her on your prayers. And now after all that conversation, oh, I thought you had something.
Get off my stool. makes me feel so tall. good morning, everyone. Birthdays we have announced is Mike Boyd. His birthday is today. Branston Arner. Yeah, Junior is July 12th. Did I say that right, Dixie? Bobby Young's birthday is July 13th, and Chuck Delaney's birthday is July 15th. Is Chuck here today? Anniversary, Kevin and Julie Bowen, July 13th. They've been married 19 years. And tomorrow, here tomorrow from 9 to 10, is the meet and greet for the new district superintendent in the church park. Back to school events. Sunday, August 15th, will be a blessing for the book bags. It includes all children and from preschool to college and also all teachers. And we'll be having a potluck after the worship in Sherwood Hall. Please bring a meat and side to share with everyone. The church will provide the plates, silverware, napkins, and drinks. And then starting on July 11th and ending on August the 8th, we will be collecting items for students returning to school. Ideas are book bags, pencils, paper, crayons, glue sticks, rulers, Kleenexes, and so forth. Please place your items in the grocery cart in the back of the sanctuary. That's all the announcements.
Thank you, Eva. And as usual, I usually forget one last thing. So I will be gone Sunday, this next Sunday. Kathy Fitzgerald will be preaching. She's the one that preached for me before when I was absent. And so please come and support her. She brings a very good message. And so after that, I'll be staying at home for a while. So you'll have to put back up with me. So let's move back into our start of our worship with the lighting of our candles and the praying of our prayer.
Thank you.
Let us all stand now and lift our voices with our first hymn this morning, "How Firm My Foundation."
Shown for what it is, because the day will bring it to light. It will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test the quality of each person's work. Word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Okay, let's come into worship this morning.
Thank you.
be seated. Let's make this our prayer. That the Lord make us the place where He resides in His sanctuary.
Or something, but don't really hurt him that much. Most kind of like this, restaurant, guess what would happen? Yeah. That's why I can find it again. No, whoops, lost it. Oh, thank you. That's a different module format. In Ephesians 6, it says that here, put on the full armor of God, so you can stand against the treachery of the devil. For the battle is not against the flesh or blood, but against the rulers and the authorities of the world power. For this darkness against the spiritual force of evil in heaven. This is why you must take up the full armor of God, so that you may resist the evil day. Be prepared for anything that takes your stand. You know, God is always there to protect us. Not just when we're all out of evil. They're talking about the different armor there. One of the things they talk about is the breastplate. That's under their breast or the front of them. And this is good so that if someone hit them with a spear, it could stop them. Well, God's armor stops sin and stuff from getting to our heart. He's always there to protect us. Now, I got to think back over my life. How many times has God protected me? And I think one time I was probably high school. We were in a car wreck. I went flying out the car, rolling down the highway 40 miles an hour. About all it is, ruined my jeans. And most of them said it's because I lit my head. I didn't get hurt. But he's always there to protect us. So, you know, whatever, you know, we have to pray to God for our protection. That helps us in praying to God to protect us through all types of life. And, you know, so, like I said, you've seen those shows and stuff. They always have a big word for what they're on. Well, listen, says God. God protects us. So when I stick that pin in, it don't pop. He protects us from evil and stuff. So remember that. Pray to God for your protection. He'll be there to protect you. Shall we pray? God, be with us in all these things. That they can resist the evil that comes for them in this world nowadays. It's always there. Protect us from it. Amen.
Amen.
Just a minute. I've got a couple of things here for you. Make sure I just make sure once today. Good thing I made some extra ones. Oh, heard my roller. I got one left from last week. Thank you, kids.
Thank you, Lord. scripture this morning. It's taken from Psalm 11, verses 1 through 7. In the Lord I take refuge. How then can you say to me, flee like a bird to your mountain? For look, the wicked bend their bows. They set their arrows against the strings to shoot from the shadows at the upright in heart. When the foundations are being destroyed, what can the righteous do? The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord is on his heavenly throne. He observes everyone on earth. His eyes examine them. The Lord examines the righteousness, but the wicked, those who love violence, he hates with a passion. On the wicked he will rain fiery coals and burning sulfur. A scorching wind will be their lot. For the Lord is righteous. He loves justice. The upright will see his face. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Well, I was saved this morning from making a grave error right at the start of my sermon this morning. I told him I was going to talk about football right off the start, and I was going to mention one of the greatest coaches there ever was, and I said, you need to put the Chiefs sandwich out there when I do this. Well, it turns out the coach I'm talking about is not a Chief. He's a Green Bay Packer. So, almost had a little football there, but Vince Lombardi, he was one of the winningest coaches who ever coached in the NFL. One day after losing a game, he called for a team meeting in the locker room. As he faced those seasoned, hardened men who knew football in and out, he held up a football and he announced, men, this is a football. And he began to remind them of some of the basics of the game. And then he said, men, we must get back to the basics. Lombardi knew the importance of never forgetting the basics of the game. He believed that the strength of the game lay in the very foundations of football, the very basics. And you know, today, it's true. It's true of our lives as Christians. If we forget the basic proverbs, the basic premise of Christianity, if we forget that we are a people of the book, of God's word, we're going to lose out in the game that we call life. That scripture bears repeating. In the Lord I put my trust. How can I say to my soul, flee as a bird to your mountain? For look, the wicked bend their bow. They make ready their arrow on the string, that they may shoot secretly at the upright heart. If the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? The Lord. The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold. His eyes test the souls of men. The Lord tests the righteous. But the Lord tells us that the wicked and the ones who love violence, his very soul hates. Upon the wicked he will rain coals. Fire and brimstone and a burning wind shall be the portion of their cup. For the Lord is righteous. He loves only righteousness. His countenance beholds the upright. You know, there was panic behind this song, behind the writing of this song. But it was not David. It was David's well-meaning counselors. Their mood was panic. David's was only peace. And because of David's peace, this song can be listed with the Psalms of confidence. Although these two different voices were speaking to David, he made up his mind only to trust in the Lord, not his counsels, only to trust in the Lord. The prophets spoke of foundations. Jesus spoke to foundations. Paul spoke to Timothy about foundations. Trust in the Lord, he said. Trust in the Lord for protection. So that gives rise to that question in the middle of the psalm. Why do they say to me, fly like a bird to the mountains for safety? Faith, our faith, stays the course. Our faith goes the extra mile. Others that don't have a strong faith, that don't have a strong foundation, will always try to escape. Will always try to escape pressure. They panic. They panic. And that psalm tells us, where do we go? Why do we need to panic when I can run straight to the Lord? Straight into the arms of our God. One day, a certain skeptic and an unbeliever basically came to Charles Spurgeon and just laid in, just started ranting and raving about him and about the subject of the Bible, and Spurgeon said nothing. The skeptic asked, Mr. Spurgeon, will you not defend the Bible? Spurgeon just laughed and retorted. He said, defend the Bible? That would be like trying to defend a lion. Just let the lion loose and he'll defend himself. Trusting God's word, you do not need to explain his word, his foundations, his love. Those don't need explaining. We only need to believe in them as Christians. Remember, I remind you today that God will spare. He will spare one righteous man from a sinful city. Remember Lot and what happened there? Our nation today, although many people don't realize this, our nation today has four foundations. Home, church, government, and schools. In Timothy, he speaks and he says, in God's truth stands firm like a foundation with this inscription. Foundation stone with this inscription. The Lord knows those who are his. And all who belong to the Lord must turn away from evil. So often, and I've told you this many times, God's word is not confusing. God's word is not complicated. He is straightforward. Always has been, always will be. Come to me. Base your lives on the foundation of my word. And I will uphold you. I will keep you from harm. We forget, in the midst of all the governments and all the people who, it's my word and this is the way it's going to be, and then the next person gets up and says the same thing, and it repeats and repeats and repeats. But I remind you this morning, God is sovereign over all. No one else. It's like just a never-ending chatter of fools. God is sovereign over everyone else. His word and his word alone are our foundation. The Lord is in his holy temple, that psalm tells us. Let the earth be silent before him. God is able to see in the hearts of all men and women. And God sees in the hearts of everyone, including the righteous. Jeremiah tells us, I have made you a tester of metals, that you may determine the quality of my people. They are the worst kind of rebels, full of slander, sound like the word today, world today. They are scarred as bronze and iron, and they need others into correction. And although God says my flames will burn out the corruption, God still offers his choice. Because the wickedness still remains in this world today. And the Lord says, I will label them rejected silver. And the Lord says, I am discarding them. There are only two choices in this world. Heaven. The Lord loves justice. The virtuous among his people will see his face. God's desire is to protect you. God is powerful. God is righteous. God is omnipresent. God is trustworthy. He is eternal. He is caring. And above all, he is triumphant. He and he alone will see us through this world. In the end, his word tells us, the book tells us, in the end, he will prevail. Even though sometimes all seems lost and we ask ourselves, where is he? We are merely longing for him, longing for his word. God is the standard. Should be our standard for all perfection, for integrity. I think back to the old days when I was growing up, where there were no contracts, no fancy lawyers writing get out of jail clauses in the contract. It was a simple handshake. It was your word, I will do this. And that's the way it is with God. There's no fancy contract. God says, come to me. Take my hand. I will honor you. I will lift you up. I will give you joy, peace, and prosperity. He loves whatever is just and good. And his love, although some people don't see it, fills this earth. Every time here lately that I start watching the news, and I don't watch all, because it's one negative thing after another. That's all. That they have to say, that's all that they see, and I feel sorry for them. For as much as they have all these horrible things on the news, we get bombarded on the radio, we get bombarded on Facebook, we get bombarded everywhere. There has ever been as much or more good in this world as evil that they present to us. And we need to open our eyes and see that. We need to remember to stay the course. That our faith will save us. That our God will save us. That he will be there. He is our foundation. And although sometimes our building and the scripture tells us this. Sometimes we might build with not the best materials. You know, we might not lay courses of brick and courses of stone. We maybe sometimes deal with a little bit of hay and a little bit of stuff thrown in there that shouldn't be there. But the psalmist tells us if we lay on his foundation, even those, or enough. as long as the foundation is strong. So our question today is, do you love justice? Dumb question, right? Do you hate evil? Second dumb question. Love your God. He will fill you with joy, such peace. Being in the big cities here over the last couple of weeks at the hospital, being in Wichita and being in Kansas City especially, I'll tell you what, there is no peace on those highways. Oh my goodness. You wonder how you're even going to get alive from one end of town to the other. People cutting each other off and people making obscene gestures and yelling and screaming at each other going across the highways. Wouldn't you just like to have some peace? I'm in the habit of, my wife can tell you that I get excited once in a while, driving across town, driving in some of that. And sometimes I've even been known to make a comment like, I better watch what I say. I'm going to make a comment like, why are all the sick people gathering here today? And that's not the path that Jesus would have me go. And so many times I'll say under my breath, Lord, just give me peace. Please, just give me peace. That is His foundation. That should be our foundation. His peace, His love. What He desires for us. I ask and I pray that God gives you that foundation today. Amen. Our closing song this morning is My Hope Is Built. If you'll please stand.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus.
I pray that as you leave this place, you leave with God and His Word, His Son and His Word, and the power of the Holy Spirit. I pray that it be with you, that it be in your heart, that it be in everything that you do.